Here we are going to learn about a topic that is arrays in C language. Here the definition is given, and the definition says that an array stores values of the same type. This is very important, means same type of values are stored in an array, and then you can store all the integers like this or all the pointed values like this. Okay, here all the integer values are stored, and whenever you go here into the next example, here all the float values are stored here, 5.1, 6.2, -7.5, means all the decimal pointed values are stored in the second example. And if you go to the character, all the characters are stored here. Okay, only character, the characters involved here are A, B and C. So let us again go to the definition of the array. So an array stores values of the same type. That is the definition of the array. Either it can store all the integers, or it can store all the pointed values, or it can store all the characters like A, B, C, D or whatever that is available on the keyboard, right? And the values are stored in continuous memory locations. So let me explain that how they are stored in the continuous locations. Next, we'll go for the explanation of how to declare, how to initialize, and how to access the values in an array. So here, for example, we can declare an array of 5 integers. How many integers we want to store at the same time? I want to store 5 integers at the same time, right? And how to declare the array, okay? Before storing the values into the array, you must declare the array. Here, as you can see, this square bracket is going to represent the array, and this is the example for storing the 5 integers. How many integers it can store? This particular array which is declared, it can store 5 integers. So this particular statement, we can call it as a declaring an integer. So what this particular statement is about? Declaring an integer array. Okay, what kind of array is this? This is an integer array. So whenever you declare like this, that is int a of 5, what will happen internally inside the RAM is, that is inside the memory, an array will be created. How many values has to be there in the array? 5 values has to be there in the array. So here we are going to store the first value, and the name of the array is A. There are some indexes are there for the array, which is going to start at 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. The minimum index is always 0, and the maximum index is nothing but the size minus 1, that is 5 minus 1. That is nothing but the 4. So whenever you write this statement automatically, this is what is going to happen inside the computer. Okay, this is what is going to happen inside the RAM or the memory of the computer. So the above statement is the declaration of an integer array that can store how many integers? It can store how many integers here? It can store 5 integers because the size is declared as 5. So next we'll go for the initializing the array. How to initialize this array? So here within the comments I have written it as nothing but the initializing an array, right? So initialization is nothing but giving some values to the array. So here by this statement 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, which is included inside the flower brackets, whenever you write this statement, what will happen? This 10 is going to be stored in the A of 0, that is the first location. The 20 will be stored in the second location. The 30 will be stored in the third location, that is the index number 2, okay, and the fourth location, that is at index number 3, 40 will be stored. Then in the fifth location, that is the index number 4, 50 will be stored. So whenever you write this statement, this is what is going to happen inside, okay, inside the memory of the computer. So here, how to access each value? The first value you can access it by A of 0. The second value you can access by A of 1. The third value you can access it by A of 2. The fourth value can be accessed by A of 3. And the fifth value, that is the last value, will be accessed by A of 4. Okay. So that's why this A of 0 is nothing but what? 10. So A of 1 is nothing but 20. Similarly, the last value A of 4 is going to be how much? It is going to be 50. Okay. Here square bracket represents what? Array. So how to identify that it is array? So whenever you see there is some square bracket, you can call it as a array. And the square bracket is used to mention the size of the array. So what is the size? How many values it can store, that is called as the size, right? Here, just like we have declared an integer array, we can also declare a float array. That is the declaring float array. So the float array is used to store the decimal pointed values. See here, as you can see here, what are the values that I have stored here? The values that are being stored here are all the decimal pointed values. So these are also similar values, right? All the values are similar. See here, in this particular one, float B of 3 means what? What will happen internally is same like the above diagram. Here, three locations are created because the size is going to be only 3. And the first location index number is 0. Second location index number is 1. And the third location index number is 2. And the values that are stored inside these locations are given as, see here, the first one is 5.1. You can see below. And the second one is 6.2. And the third one is minus 7.5. Okay, this is the memory representation and the name of the array is B here. Okay. And we can also declare a float, that is a character array. Okay. So whenever you declare a character array with size 5, a character array CH will be created inside the memory with 5 locations. By this statement, this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3, and this is 4. Okay, so whenever you initialize the character array, that is CH is equal to ABC, the first value will be A, the second value will be C, and the third value will be B, and the third value is C. And one more character will be appended by the computer, that is the backslash 0. Okay, so what about this location? Here, this location will be left empty. This location will be wasted. This location will be left empty. Why it is left empty? Because the size is how much? 5, right? But out of 5, how many are filled? Only 3 are filled, and one more is filled by the backslash 0. It is a rule in the C language that every string or a group of characters is terminated by backslash 0. The backslash 0 will be added by the computer at the end of every string in C language. And one more thing we have not discussed here is, whenever you declare an integer, let us say int A of 3. Let us say I am declaring an integer array with a size as 3. Three locations are created. This first one is called as a of 0, and the second one we are calling it as a of 1, and the third one we are calling it as a of 2. The name of the array is a. Let us take the first value as 10 and the second value as 20 and the third value as 30. So what is the data, that is the memory that is allocated for the first value, that is 10, is 2 bytes. Why? Because it is an integer. Again, 2 bytes is allocated for 20. Again, two more bytes is allocated for 30. Tell me, what is the size of the array, size of this array? The size of this array is nothing but the sum of the sizes of all the data, that is 2 plus 2 plus 2. So the size of the array is 6. Similarly, whenever you declare a float array, let us say float b of 3, not necessarily 3, you can take any value. So similarly, an array b is created with 3 locations, and if you take some values, let us say b is equal to some 1.0, 2.0 and 3.0, let us say. So 1.0 will be stored here, 2.0 will be stored here, and the 3.0 will be stored here. How much memory is allocated? 4 bytes and the 4 bytes. The total memory is how much? 12 bytes. For example, let us say the starting address of this one is 1000 or 100. What is the next address? It will be 104, because 4 bytes, the 4 bytes difference is there. Means from 100 to 104, 1.0 is stored. From 104 to 108, the 2.0 will be stored. This will be stored from 104th byte to 108th byte. So this is the memory, that is the bytes, how much size is allocated inside the memory, that I have discussed here. And let us go for the example program. So we will start tracing the program from here. Whenever you declare this array and initialize this array, the 3 values are stored in the array, that is 10, 20 and 30. And the name of the array is A. What is the name of the array? The name of the array is A. And the first value we can call it as A of 0. And the second value we are going to call it as A of 1. And the third value we are going to call it as A of 2. So whenever you print A of 0, %LD, because it is an integer, what will be printed? 10 will be printed. Whenever you take this one, the A of 1, 20 will be printed onto the screen. It is a simple program actually. A of 2 means 30 will be printed onto the screen. Okay, this is the internal execution. Let us go for the practical execution of this program. The same program I am executing here. I am running the program. So we have got 10, 20, 30, right? Similarly, how to declare a float array? Instead of int, you change the data type to float, and instead of A, you can take A also. I am taking it as B, and you can take some values like 10.0 and 20.1 and 30.5 I am taking. Okay, now how the program is going to change? If you run this program like this, it is going to give some errors, because %LD, you have to change it to %LF, because we have to print the float values. And instead of A of 0, I am going to change it as B of 0, right? Similarly, instead of the second one, I am taking %LF and changing it to B of 1, and I am changing the third one also %LF, and I am changing this to B of 2. And let us execute this program. See here, as you can see, 10.0, 20.1 is there. After point, after the decimal point, there will be 6 zeros always. So that's why the output is displayed like this. Okay. So again, let us change and illustrate how a character array will be declared. Char ch, I'm taking it as ch. Here let us take the size as 5. Okay. And the characters can be anything. I'm taking it as Ramu. How to declare it here? Directly you can declare like this also. If you want to display them as a group of characters also, you can do it. See here, use the flower bracket. And if you want to store Ramu into that, or say group of characters, right, comma A, comma A, single quote, comma, the next character is M, comma, the next character is U with single quote. I'm closing this array. So the format specifier for character is percentile C. Here CH of 0. Again percentile C backslash n. CH of 1. Percentile C. CH of 2. If you still, you can go continue, but only 3 characters are enough. I'm going to display RAM only. Run it. So RAM is displayed. So this is the way how you can execute the programs on character array, integer array, and the float array. That is the integer array, float array, and the character array.